So I'm sure as many of you are well aware at this point, the Alpha is out this weekend for Call of Duty Modern Warfare, and a lot of people are playing it. A lot of people are talking about it, giving their opinions on it, trying to basically get as many wins as possible. But I wanted to take a step aside today and talk about something else, something not a lot of people are talking about, and that is, of course, the campaign. As you can probably tell by the title of this video, I wanted to talk about old Call of Duty characters, whether that be Soap, Ghost, Roach, coming back in the present Call of Duty game. Now, there's been rumors going around about this for a while, but nothing was ever actually confirmed by the developers until last Monday when they were announcing the 2v2 alpha. They said this.
So it's still Modern Warfare through and through, complete with some familiar characters as well.
So notice that he didn't say familiar character just talking about Captain Price. He said familiar characters, and that kind of leaves the question, who are those characters going to be? And since then, I've put in a lot of research, and there's a lot of rumors going around that I wanted to address, starting off with this picture that you're seeing here. This is the cover for the Game Informer magazine, and a lot of people are speculating that these characters are actually some reincarnated old characters, so I wanted to address that first, and then I wanted to dig in and actually look at who could potentially be coming back based off of what we know about the current Modern Warfare game. Now, as you guys know on this channel, I love doing these type of videos where we dive in, look at characters' backstories, and kind of get to the bottom of what's going on behind the scenes. And we've done many of these videos before with individual characters like Captain Price or smaller characters like the Specialist from Black Ops 3. And I plan on doing more of these throughout Modern Warfare, but I thought a good place to start was with the speculation of which characters were actually going to be returning in Modern Warfare. And once again, this is going to begin with this picture. So the picture that you're looking at here is the cover for the Game Informer magazine focusing on Call of Duty Modern Warfare. And obviously the familiar face that most people are going to recognize is close to the middle, Captain Price. You can see the Union Jack on his left arm, on top of that wearing his classic bucket hat and having his beard. But the face that a lot of people are talking about is not his, it's the person off to the left there. A lot of people are speculating that this is an actual returning character from a previous Call of Duty game. And my god, did the speculation go wild. Some people saying that this is Simon Ghost Riley without his mask on. Others saying that this is Gary Roach Sanderson without the classic ski goggles and helmet. No, it's not either of them. And people even went as far as saying that this is actually Soap MacTavish with a different haircut and a beard. The one thing you may notice is that Soap MacTavish has no tattoos on his right arm, but this person we are looking at here absolutely does. No, this is not any of them. And I know that this is technically a reboot and it could be the same character that actually just looks different, but that's not the case here. And on top of that, the character we're looking at here is actually much more similar to Gaz from Call of Duty Modern Warfare. They definitely look the most similar out of any characters comparatively. But as it turns out, we actually know every single one of these characters who are in this picture. So first, let me explain who all of these characters are. Now, they really haven't shown off much about the single player in this game, but the reason why I know this is because they showed us a lot of the single player when I went to go see the game early in May. So the first character that we're looking at today is the one on the right of the screen, the girl. This girl is named Farah Karim. I probably butchered her name, but basically, you start with her as a 7 to 10 year old girl in Uzbekistan, and eventually she ends up joining Captain Price's group in Bravo 6. And by the way, Uzbekistan is a made up country. It's not a real place. They just made it up for the game. Now, another one of the main characters in the game is actually Farah's brother named Hadir Karim. Now, this character you just barely get to see in the trailer. He is the young kid staring off over the gas, as you're seeing on screen here. But you also get to see him as an adult, but we haven't seen that yet as of any trailers. But it is possible that Hadir is the person second from the left that we are looking at here. However, I actually think that this is someone different named Kyle Garrick. This person you actually see twice throughout the original trailer for Modern Warfare as a police officer for the Metropolitan Police Service in Britain. And then the final mystery person, the one that kind of looked like Gaz, this person, all we know for a name so far, is Alex. And the only other thing we know about this character is that he works for the CIA, and this was the original render for this character that you can see here. Once again, wearing those same headphones with the same type of beard, same type of hair, this is very clearly Alex. We don't have a last name for this character yet. So that explains every character in this picture. But what about the characters returning to the game, like they said at the very beginning?
So it's still Modern Warfare through and through, complete with some familiar characters as well.
So who are these familiar characters? Now, we don't know anything 100%, but we can speculate based off of what we know about Modern Warfare. So first of all, the main group of soldiers that you follow are Captain Price's soldiers, and he is captaining the Bravo 6 group, the same group that he captained back in Call of Duty 4. Now, this is not an American task force like Task Force 141 from Modern Warfare 2 in Modern Warfare 3, which means the main soldiers you can expect Captain Price to be working with in this game are SAS soldiers. AKA, there are three soldiers from Call of Duty 4 that could potentially return. The first of which, the main one, the one that I expect more than anything else, is John MacTavish, AKA Soap MacTavish. I'm guessing somewhere along the lines you will be fighting along his side at some point throughout this game, as he was originally a member of Bravo 6 and then went to Task Force 141 in Modern Warfare 2. The other one is Gaz. We already briefly talked about him, but he was also an SAS soldier as well. Then the other one from Call of Duty 4 was Nikolai. This was a side character that picked up throughout several different Call of Duty games, and actually, believe it or not, he was one of the few characters that was left alive at the end of Modern Warfare 3. Now, from the Modern Warfare 2 and Modern Warfare 3 games, there is two main soldiers that you can see joining the game, the first of which is Simon Ghost Riley. This character was actually a part of the SAS before he was in Task Force 141. You just didn't really get to see that part of his career. So once again, it is possible that he is in Bravo 6 team within Call of Duty Modern Warfare. Similarly, Gary Roach Sanderson was also a member of the British SAS before joining Task Force 141. So for both of them, it is very possible that we see them as a member of Bravo 6 or another SAS soldier within Modern Warfare. Now, the one character that I think a lot of people want to see, but I don't know if they will be able to work into this story, is Yuri. So Yuri was in Modern Warfare 3, and before joining Task Force 141, he was actually a Russian soldier, which we don't really know how the Russian involvement is going to work in Modern Warfare, so that would be a tough one to work in. Now, as far as the rest of the soldiers throughout the different Modern Warfare games, the rest are mainly American soldiers working for other divisions, whether that be the Rangers or Task Force 141. So I think it'll be a lot more difficult to work them into the game, but it is possible because, as we talked about before, Alex, one of the main characters in the game, is actually a CIA agent that is working with Bravo 6. So in my opinion, the two most obvious characters that I think that will be in there, whether they just be cameos or as main characters, are both Soap MacTavish and Ghost. I think those are the two most iconic and most recognizable characters. Now, the others that I haven't talked about that I would love to see, and I don't know how they would do it, are actually the bad guys from the Modern Warfare games, whether that be Imran Zakayev, Makarov, General Shepard, or anything like that. I would love to see those brought forward in various ways, whether they just be characters that show up for cameos, for one-liners or something, or just mentioned in passing by. I'm really interested to see what they do with that throughout the entire campaign, because I'm sure there's going to be some little Easter eggs spread throughout that campaign. But really, that is all the information we have as of right now. They haven't gave us any specifics about individual characters, but I'm guessing over the next coming weeks, we're going to start to see some teasers about the campaign, about maybe even Spec Ops, and with that, we might get to see these characters. The other thing that I would love to see is these old characters, like Soap, like Ghost, come in as operators in multiplayer, because as we saw, there's a bunch of characters they're bringing in, but none of them are from the past. So I think that would be really cool as well. But you can let me know down in the comment section below which characters you'd like to see return to the franchise. Would you just want them to be cameos? Would you want them to come back as full characters in the game? Let me know what you think down in the comments. I'm really curious to hear what you guys have to say. And of course, as more changes, as we get these teasers, as we get more information, I will keep you guys updated with everything Modern Warfare. So if you're not already, make sure you're subscribed to the channel and make sure you have notifications turned on. And of course, once the game actually comes out, I'm going to be digging through that campaign, looking for information and cameos for these characters. As you know, that's the kind of thing I love to do. But guys, as always, if you enjoyed the video, make sure you hit that like button. I hope you enjoyed the video. And until next time, guys, peace out. We are reaching for the stars, but we're making this too hard.